Good morning, children. Welcome back. Hope you all are good. As today, we are not going to do anything new. So let's revise the topics we have done so far.
So in chapter number 1, India in Color, you have learned about the different tribes of India, particularly of the states Assam, Andhra Pradesh and Nagaland. So let's revise with the beautiful pictures. In Assam, tribe's population is about 12.5% of total population. Each tribe is unique in its tradition, culture, dress, etc. In spite of having official language Assamese, each tribe speaks its own language. And the major tribes of Assam are Ao, Angami, Garo, Dimasa, Bodo, Deori, etc. Next was your Nagaland, the tribes of Nagaland. It is a northeastern state bounded by Myanmar on the east, Arunachal Pradesh on north, and on the west side Assam is there. And this state is mostly mountainous. Major tribes of Nagaland are Angami, Ao, Chang, Zeliang, etc. It is basically a land of agriculture. Their main festival is Hornbill, and they generally perform folk dances in groups, mostly in every festive occasions. And your next was Andhra Pradesh, the tribes of Andhra Pradesh. The tribes of Andhra Pradesh are technically more developed than the other tribes of India. Around 20 different tribes are there living in Andhra Pradesh. They are living at forest-based mountains. And the names of some tribes in Andhra Pradesh are Jatapu, Goda, Lambda, Kolam, Chenchu, Savara, etc. And children, in chapter number 2, Headwears of India, you learned about the different headwears all over the country, like from Nagaland, Rajasthan, Taranga from Kashmir, and Japi from Assam. Let's revise with the beautiful pictures. Nagaland is one of the northeastern states of India. The Nagas are known for their rich culture and tradition. In Nagaland, headwear is a symbol of power and honor. It must be worn or inherited rather than simply bought. Each tribe has its own style of headwear. Most of the headwears are made with cane or bamboo and also decorated with an animal part like bird's feathers, beaks or animal skulls. Next was the headwear of Rajasthan, that is Safar Pagri. As you know that Rajasthan is a rich state in culture and heritage. There are many varieties of turban, safa, pagri are there. This is a traditional headwear for men. The turban, known as safa in Rajasthan, is the most popular men's accessory. In Rajasthan, the turban is a matter of pride and respect. The safas are very useful in any special occasions like marriage or any other function, as well as they wear it for protection from the harsh desert sun. Next was your Tiranga. Basically, it's Taranga, T-A-R-A-N-G-A, Taranga. It is the typical headwear worn by Kashmiri Pandit women until the late 1960s. Now, its only place it's as a ritual and by tradition to be worn in a classical way on the bride's head as a bridal gear or on her wedding day. This headwear was of very significant and historical importance, because it was an appreciation reward from Jagatguru Adi Shankaracharya during her stay in Kashmir. Next headwear was Japi from Assam. Japi is a traditional conical hat from Assam, which is made from tightly woven bamboo or cane and large palm leaf. The word Japi derives from Jap, meaning the bundle of palm leaves. It is worn at ceremonies and is placed on the head of a special guest. It is also used as a decorative item at home.
Originally, Japi was an agricultural headwear by farmers to protect themselves from rain. So children, hope you revised all the topics. And please don't forget to like and subscribe my video. Thank you so much.